This week, Ultimaker released CURA version 4.0. It's been in beta for a while, I've been playing with it, but now it's officially released. So let's take a look at version 4.0 of CURA, and we'll compare it to version 3.6 on today's Filament Friday. This week's episode is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. And here's CURA version 3.6. I've used this on the channel many times. I've got my calibration cube loaded. You can see the settings on the side. This is the standard CURA that we're used to. But now let's look at the new 4.0. And here's the new CURA 4.0. It just looks cleaner and more modern than 3.6. And you've got a full screen view of your 3D print. The settings on the side, well, they're temporarily gone. And there's more settings at the top bar. So let's dive a little deeper and see what the differences are. Always visible at the top is the profile selected, your layer height, your infill percentage, your supports on or off, or your bed adhesion on or off. And from there, you can click on this bar and you get the full settings, everything you want to change, just like you had in 3.6. You can scroll through this, change different settings, and then collapse it if you want. Back in 3.6, the printer you selected, the filament you selected are all up here at the top. In 4.0, it's over here to the left in the top bar, always visible, always available. In 3.6, you could click on the object and a menu of options would show up on the left, such as resizing it to 150% of its original size. Same thing in 4.0. You click on it, you have the same menu, it's just a little cleaner looking. In version 3.6, after you slice the model, you can go to the top drop-down menu and select Layer View. From there, you can scroll through the layers or play an animation. In 4.0, after you slice it, you now have a preview mode. There's a button at the top and one down here next to save to file. Click on that, get rid of your settings, and it defaults to the layer view mode. So now you have a full screen view to scroll through the layers or run an animation. In version 3.6, a color scheme chart to show you different layers and different features would automatically show up in the layer view. In 4.0, you have to select it from this top menu here, and it'll show you basically the same features. What I don't like is you can't move it. So if you want to see your model, you actually have to move the model to the side. So I hope they change this so you can move this chart anywhere on the screen. In version 3.6, you can also select from the drop-down menu the X-ray view and see inside your model. This can be very handy to see infill or different features that may not show up in the solid view. In 4.0, X-ray view is under the view types menu up here at the top. You select X-ray view, and then you get that same X-ray view that you had in 3.6, but now on a full screen. At the top, there's also a monitor button. This is for the CURA Connect feature for Ultimaker printers that have a wireless network capability. In the upper right-hand corner is the Marketplace button. Click on that and the menu of plugins shows up. These are all plugins that you can add to your CURA 4.0. There's also a material selection. These are all the companies that have materials already set up that you can install in CURA. All the settings and everything else like Matter Hackers has for its Nylon G. In the upper right of that window is the installed button, and here you can scroll through all the plugins that you have already installed or that were installed by default into CURA 4.0. In CURA 3.6, time details would show up when you hovered over the estimated print time. In 4.0, there's a little I button. You hover over that and it'll show you the print specifications. There is one issue I did find with 4.0, could be just a bug, but if you're moving a profile from CURA 3 to CURA 4, this works fine. You can import that profile, say someone gave one to you and you want to use, that works fine. But once it's in 4.0, and say you make some modifications, you want to send it back to that person that's using 3.6, it'll say it loaded, but once you import it, it doesn't show up. It doesn't accept it. So 3 to 4 works, but 4 to 3 doesn't. Post-processing scripts, this is something I showed in a previous video. It's right up here under extensions, post-processing, modify G-code. And all the same scripts as 3.6 are available in 4.0. Pause at height and filament change, two very popular ones. Filament change, you just select it, and then you tell it which layer you want to change filaments at. It'll then remove or retract the filament, and then scroll all of it out so you can make a quick change and pause the printer. So all this is available, and once you select it, the little symbol shows up down here next to the slice button, and that'll bring the whole menu up, so you don't have to go to that top menu. That's no different than 3.6. So overall, I like CURA 4.0. It just seems cleaner and fresher, and I like the full screen capability. And they fixed a lot of bugs according to the release notes, so that's a good thing as well. So going forward, I think I'm going to start using CURA 4.0.
If you use CURA 4.0, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. March 29th through the 31st, I will be at the Midwest RepRap Festival. It's one of the biggest 3D printing conferences in the world, and it's in the middle of nowhere, Goshen, Indiana. We move into town and take it over, and it's all 3D printing. It's just awesome. So if you want to attend, stop by and see me. I'll have my $179 Ender 3 that I've highly modified, and also my original $179 Fabricator Mini that I bought 3 years ago. Maybe a few other things too, but stop by and say hi. So that's it for this week. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos that are popping up. If you want to help support the channel, Patreon's one way, or just buy through the affiliate links in the description below. It all helps a lot. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.